Hello YouTubers! Today we're going to look at my mixer, my Trommel that separates sand and soil and mixes and prepares potting soil and so forth. I was looking on YouTube because I had made one that I manually turned and it was very difficult, and so I wanted a motorized one. But I realized that everybody was having problems getting the parts. They were having to go to junk yards and try to take motors out of treadmills and stuff like that. So I found a motor that I could bolt on to directly onto the motor for direct drive like that. And if you'll see, the motor is 12 volts. It's very powerful because it has 2,000 pounds of torque. And it's portable because it can run off of a battery. You'll see up here, I have one of these battery jump starters that I use, but you can hook it into a car battery, a tractor battery, a lawnmower battery, or if you're using it in a permanent place, you can get one of these little inverters. And these things are about $20, but they're very powerful. I haven't seen any 12-volt motors that couldn't pull. So I built all this for about, the best thing about this is everything is off the shelf. You don't have to go to a junkyard, pull parts, try to find motors and pulleys, belts, sprockets, reduction gears and all that kind of stuff. Everything can be bought off the shelf for about $100, $150. The motor is about $60.
Oh.
The casters are $5 a piece, so if you use four of them, that's $20. The lumber only takes three sticks of lumber. You can see right here I have the boards cut for making another video of how to put all this together that I'm going to offer for sale for $25. So you can send me email if you want it. TBLOUNT7. The number 7 at yahoo.com. I'll post that in the writing. This is all the hardware that's needed to do this assembly. And so the hardware, including a screen, is probably about $20. A barrel, you can pull a barrel off of Craigslist, shouldn't be but $10 or $20. So total, including probably some taxes or inflation, shouldn't be over $150, and it's very easy. It's all off the shelf. And one thing about this one that makes it unique that I have never seen on any of them is you can use different types of different sizes of mesh in your screen. If you want to do that, or if you're just going to stick with one side, you can lay it in here. So what you think? Let's start with the 1/8 screen and make a demo. You slip it in there. Turn it on. We'll throw some dirt in. I found some rocks, so we'll see how they work in there too. Thank you. also throw in some mulch, like this is from cane tops, like these up here. Sugar cane has a lot of sugar in the stalks and the tops that the critters in the soil like to feed on. So it will mix if you just throw in different kinds. So if some falls out, you could turn this in if you wanted to keep it from falling out, but if some of it falls out, you can just throw it back in there. Some of this is wet. That's a switch I put on, of course. Sometimes this wants to spin a little bit, but it'll start back. If you wanted to, you could put some zip ties to hold it in if you just had a string. But another good thing about this type of setup is when you get through, you can just pull it out and dump all this out. If you want to sift big rocks, you can get a larger mesh. One thing I'd like to mention, I'm not a real big gardener, but if you mix this mosquito bits, it will kill fungus and gnats that gets into your roots. So that's a good thing to throw some of that into your soil every once in a while. Another good thing about this is, when I run my sugar cane through a chipper, the sugar cane here, the tops, I run it through the chipper, it wants to blow everywhere. And if you, please come over here. And if you want to add coco coir, it's very hard to get that broken down, but you can run it through a chipper. But if you put that in a chipper, it will just blow it all over the hill and all over the place, and you won't capture it. But if you put your chipper here so it's blowing in there and throw a piece of plastic over it, you won't lose this through the chipper blowing so hard. So like I said, it's pretty easy. It'll take some time to do it. I'll say the difficulty level is really about a 2 or 3, maybe 4. It's pretty easy. You just have to drill. You have to drill about 20 holes. The only difficult part is getting those bolts onto the motor, because it's hard to reach into the barrel and do that. But you could reach through here and probably do it by yourself. But if you had some help, that would be easy. I will show you the tools. You really need a drill press, but only for about 4 holes that you drill. They need to be good. They'd be hard to do with a hand drill. You probably could do it, but if you have a drill press, that will make that project much easier. I will go all through over all this in my video. Also, if you have a compound miter saw, you can make your 15-degree angle cuts on your material very easy. You can do it with a skill saw and just make the whole frame square. Don't worry about it being in a shape like that. And then if you have extension on a drill, you can put the screws inside the barrel. You need a hand drill also. You can drill some holes with this. You only use about 4 different bolts. Mostly you're going to use 1/4-inch bolts, but on the 1/4-inch bolts I like to go a little larger. That's a 21/64 bolt. That'll give a little play for the 1/4-inch bolts. And there are several bolts that will be 1/4-inch. And this one here is 3/16. That's just to make a pilot hole for my lag screws so it doesn't split the wood. And there's four holes you need to drill out to a half inch to accommodate. The two you have to have is a side grinder with a cutoff blade, or what I like to call my tabo blade. And I put these big ones on the little ones here because they cut so much. You can actually cut these slats out of the boards of a barrel once they're marked in 5 minutes. It hardly takes any time. And please do not do any of this work and use any of these power tools without gloves, safety glasses, and ear protection. Okay, one other thing I'd like to show you over here is if you have perlite in there and you use the Aztec brand, it's a little bit big and it won't go through the holes as easily. Even the half inch holes easier, but other brands like this is much smaller. If you want to make it easier to roll around, you can put casters on the bottom. I suppose that's pretty much all I've got to add for today. So if you want a video, please check roofinghoist.com. I made videos and sold about over 100 instructional videos on making roofing hoists. And I also sell the roofing hoist platforms that I can ship out too. That sponsors most of my work here. Thank you for your time. Enjoy.